Yo, what's up? I'm Lauv, and you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I'm Zach Monson, and welcome to a very special edition of Stingray PausePlay here at Osheaga 2018 with international mega superstar Lauv.
Who's that?
What's up? That's you, baby. You didn't know? You didn't know?
No.
That's you now. Did you not know that? You're opening for Ed Sheeran. You're going triple platinum. That's you now. When are you going to just realize that and be okay with that fact?
I'm still a bowl of cereal.
Yeah, right.
Literally.
Who doesn't love a bowl of cereal?
True. Actually,
right.
Fair.
Right?
Fair.
Exactly. What is your happiest musical childhood memory?
I think I look back on when I first started playing guitar. And just like, I would look up like every Green Day song and just like tabs and just literally would spend all day. Yeah. That's like when I first fell in love, I like wouldn't come out at all. Yeah. That's why I'm so pale. It's 'cause I just don't go outside. I literally would just like tabs all day. Yeah.
Well, Dookie was definitely the first album I ever bought my own money. That album's phenomenal.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
What were your parents playing when you were a kid that you loved, and what did they play that you didn't really like at all?
See, that's the thing is my parents, I wasn't really raised on any particular music. Like my parents like didn't make me listen to everything. I'm honestly sort of jealous of kids that are like, yeah, I grew up, my parents were always playing like whatever, you know, whatever it is that they grew up listening to. I kind of always like doing my own thing. Like I had like a babysitter who like showed me how to use like LimeWire or whatever when I was like 10, I feel like. And I just started downloading random music.
Good irresponsible child care.
It was great.
I like
it
that
was great.
A lot.
Yeah.
You've spent a lot of time writing for other artists and now you're the artist. You know, is being the artist the backup plan, or was writing for other artists the backup plan? Which was kind of the dream for you?
I mean, when I first started writing, I didn't even know you could write for other people, so I always wanted to be an artist.
Yeah.
I just wanted to make music and express myself and have fun and play shows. But I kind of spent years, like during the MySpace era, grinding it out and like, you know, my sister would drive me and my best friends on tour, and we'd play literally. Like we showed up to a venue one day, I think in like middle of nowhere, Tennessee, and they like forgot that we had booked the show. And so like the only people that showed up were like some of like, I think it was like their family that was working at like Papa John's that like came through just to support us. But like I played so many shows to zero people and like begged people to come to shows and like literally paid to play shows.
Yeah. Oh,
you know what I'm saying? Like, you would buy the tickets and you would hope you could sell them. So I kind of gave up on the artist thing like when I was graduating high school. And that's when I started writing and producing and kind of like focusing on just the music and like trying to like pitch songs to other people and work at studios and stuff like that. And then it was like when I wrote my first song, The Other, that was like the first song I'd written in years. It was like, I have to, like, this has to be mine.
Which is a beautiful, and that was like, beautiful song.
Thank you, man. I appreciate
such
it.
A good song.
Thank you.
Working in the music business for a long time, you kind of interned at studios all over the place. What was the biggest lesson that you took that you kind of use still today?
I think because I'm not a patient person, I think it was just a constant like test of patience, you know, like being like working at, you know, being an intern at a studio and being cool to just like run around and like grab the rider items and like the specific this size Fiji water that had to be room temperature and this size that had to be in the fridge.
Thanks,
Beyonce. It was that specific. It was like super specific stuff like that. And just like cleaning and like staying up all night. I think it was just like patience. Yeah.
So we asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question. That artist is Billie Eilish. And the question is so fun.
Yeah.
The question is,
hey, I'm Billie Eilish and my question for you is, what is one thing you don't miss at all?
Oh, having braces. I don't miss having braces at all.
Good answer.
Braces, like the whole works. There's like the worst times in my life.
How long?
I probably had a good like two, three years of that. Yeah.
Did you get like name called? Were you one of those kids?
Like, no. I didn't get like name called, but it was
just
like
a pain.
Painful.
Yeah.
And like especially when you get like some new like expansion or something.
Yeah, then
couldn't talk.
Or like a popcorn
and it's
curl
like,
in there.
I already have a lisp, so it was like you couldn't even imagine the type of lisp that I had.
Right.
It was bad.
Yeah, that's not good. Your big single, I Like Me Better, gone. What was it, like triple platinum? Was that what you just got? Double platinum?
Yeah,
triple platinum?
It's crazy.
It's an insane number of sales. You even have it, you know, like Kids Bop has done your song, which is, I think, the like standard of have I made it or not, is that your song's on a Kids Bop album, which is so, have you heard it?
I have.
Yeah, it's a little,
You can't help but be like, okay, like this is so sick. Like,
it's
kids,
pretty,
crazy.
It's pretty fun.
It's crazy.
what's next? You know, it's you've given us this, what you call a playlist, two playlists, really, of like, you know, 35 songs altogether. When can we expect that full polished album?
So I just started like writing for my debut album, which feels really good to say. It's like that official, like, because I feel like everybody's like, when's the album?
But it feels weird that you don't already have an album. You know, you're so recognized and loved by people now. It's strange to think you don't have one out.
I didn't want to call I Met You When I Was 18. There's a fly. I didn't want to call I Met You When I Was 18 an album just because, like, you know, the very first song I released that's on that playlist is called The Other. And it was all these songs are kind of coming out of order for a while as I didn't kind of like put together that they were all this story. So I wanted to give the proper album, like, you know, its own, like, time.
And does it have a name? Are there collaborations you can say anything about?
I've definitely been doing some
collabs.
Will
the color blue be involved?
I think blue will definitely be involved. When I kind of, like, the whole idea of I Met You When I Was 18 came to me and I was putting out I Like Me Better and all this and that, like, I was, that's, like, when the idea of blue came to me. And then the idea of, like, a blue rose, which is like supposed to represent unrequited love, and I was like, "That's like the entire
meaningful,
fucking,
yeah,
like
exactly, makes the exact sense."
So, and then I'd also been kind of inspired by this artist Eve Klein that did all this like weird, like abstract, deep blue paint stuff. And so then I started covering objects in blue paint, and kind of like that became like the whole thing for me. And then Blue Boy. And all that. So
it works. I like it, man.
It's fun.
Well, look, here at Stingray, we're so proud of you and kind of have had the pleasure of watching you just skyrocket since you released that song. So just, I'm just so happy to talk to you and just can't wait to see the album and see where you go from here, man.
Thank you so much.
You can hear Lauv on Stingray Music's Hitlist channel, Eclectic Electronic channel, Dance Club, and Total Hits Australia, Total Hits Germany, and of course, all over Stingray Music's Vibes channel. It's available now on our mobile app and our web player. Don't forget to like us, leave us a comment, and of course, subscribe to keep up with all the newest episodes of Stingray PausePlay. Bye.